Hi Horrorfly, welcome to my closet. Another episode of HFRates. This is Jasveen Kaur. हम एक और कौर को ले आए हैं आज.
Hello.
Hello Nimrit.
Hi.
How are you feeling today?
I'm feeling sleep deprived but super excited.
Is this the खतरो के खिलाड़ी?
I think so. I think this hangover is just not withering away. I don't know why, but yeah.
And I see you are too much into shirts and something which is what we call loungewear.
Yeah.
Do you mind showing me?
Of course, I'd love to. Let's go. There are a lot of days where I feel like I just want to be easy, you know, especially when you're going for meetings. I think it's very important to just feel yourself and not be conscious of what you're wearing, and that's when, you know, shirts come into play. Like, this is one of my most favorite shirts.
I love the print.
Thank you. In fact, I wore it on one of my previous reality shows too.
Was it a Big Boss?
Yes.
Okay. You have a pretty sporty streetwear style aesthetic, right?
Yes. Like you said, aesthetic. Ooh. I think this is also something which is a go-to. I mean, you can literally wear this when you are entering a gym. Also, if you're meeting someone for coffee. So I love to pick up pieces which are, I don't know, like utility based and not restrictive in that sense.
Definitely.
And of course,
can we look at this shirt also? Oh my god, this is so fancy.
I think I've worn it only twice, but this one's from Zara. I think a little drama on the sleeves is a must, which is why I picked this particular piece up. And like I said, I'm also obsessed with staple whites. This is one of my favorite jackets. I end up wearing this every time I'm at the airport. This is also again an article that I've worn in one of my reality shows.
Is it Khatro Ki Khiladi or Big Boss?
This one is Big Boss.
Okay,
yeah.
Big Boss.
Actually,
fans.
No, I wore this for Khatro too. Oh, I wore this for Big Boss and Khatro. That's how obsessed I am. And I think it's also important to repeat your outfits.
Definitely.
Yeah, very, very important. And if I have to talk about
the famous fati hui jeans.
Yes.
Which parents don't approve of.
So this one again is by the same brand that I love, Human. I just love these pair of jeans. I think it's super cool. Again,
yes.
I've worn it on camera before. I think I've wore a lot of the clothes that I also keep repeating, which is great. But I think this is like a very cool statement piece.
Also, something that I wanted to know from you is that you're from Gurgaon.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And now you're a Bombay girl.
Yeah.
So, is there a transition in the way you're styling yourself now?
Absolutely. Like,
what
everything
you
that you see here,
okay,
was the teenage me, which was super blingy.
Blingy. The Delhi girl,
the out there girl. Most of these outfits over here are also outfits that I wore during Miss India. In fact, I would love to show you now that you said a Delhi girl.
Yes.
So now this piece, there's this one particular market, I don't remember the exact name, but it's closer to Green Park. And they have this entire northeastern community that's settled there, and
yes,
they're big on fashion,
yes,
right? And they have great, great stores out,
yes,
there.
Yes.
So for my Miss India, like, I picked up this particular piece from there.
Look. Yeah.
Yeah, it's so cool.
And how much was it for back then?
Honestly, I don't think I spent more than 1,000 rupees.
Henna?
Yeah. And it's like great. So this is a designer dress. Again, if you see how that Hoskas wala area also has
Ogan,
a lot of,
yeah,
all of those designer stores.
Yes.
So this was also one of those, you know, pieces that I picked. Again, I wore this for Miss India.
Miss India.
Now this.
Ooh.
This is something, again, I wore for Khatro.
Okay.
It's a Bershka dress. But again, my obsession with
The brand
and denim,
yes,
I think it pretty much goes hand in hand.
But tell me one thing, I can see a lot of bags also.
Yes.
Obsession. So what is this obsession with bags?
I think it's an every girl obsession. I hope so. I don't want to be the only one. I think
no,
it's an every girl.
Yeah,
all
yeah,
of us, yeah. And like I said, I'm an absolute hoarder. So I just feel like I've coded my way into having a lot of the bags that I do. You can see, and I've also like to separate and segregate most of them.
Yes.
So I have to show you the first luxury bag that I purchased.
Okay.
Obviously, firsts are special, right? I saved a lot for this.
So this was after when?
This was when I wrapped Choti Sardani. I think I could have bought it sooner, but I don't think I had the time.
To go out and select.
Actually, to select or even to think that, you know, this is something I want for myself. But this was the first luxury bag that I bought. In fact, I bought this classic Gucci on the same day. I just love how tiny it is. It can turn into a sling. You know, you can have it like a crossbody or just carry it. You can also have it on the waist, which is great. And I love this color. Even this, I just love the fact that
it goes with everything then.
Yeah, pretty much. Like, it could be like a staple statement. I don't know, like, I just like how quirky it is.
It is. But is it anything that you shed like a bomb amount on and now you regret? Ki, yaar, maine kyun le liya?
Okay, no regrets. No regrets.
No regrets while we hold one.
Yeah. No regrets at all. But did we have a bit much, maybe? The Gucci Bamboo collection, but I just...
You only live once.
It's okay. I also wanted to see this one.
Yes, I love this one also.
This one?
The music player thing.
Yeah, yes. Exactly. So this was an older bag that I picked up
from
Philly. I have never worn it.
It's a debut on Hotfly, guys.
Yay! I don't know when am I going to wear it. I was like, maybe Halloween? I don't know. It still hasn't happened, but yeah, thank you for my debut. Finally, it makes sense to have gotten this bag. Yeah, in fact, I want to show you one more bag.
Yes.
This one is a very, very, very old Coach.
It looks like a very vintage.
Very vintage Coach, but this was my Nani's. So I think she must have given this to me maybe back in 2002 is when I took it from her, and I didn't know what Coach meant, or I didn't know, but I just kept it. So now there are moments when I do style this bag.
My God.
Because I feel like vintage is vintage, right?
Definitely.
Yeah.
It's actually way cooler than anything you
exactly,
have.
Exactly. Exactly.
I know. And talking about Nanimas, guys, my Nanima was obsessed with the idea that I'm going and shooting with not Nimrit. Choti Sardarni.
Yay, love you, Nani Ma.
So we cannot go away from here without talking about the show. And if you've picked something from it, because I remember your jewelry was a rage back then.
It was a pain to wear.
I know.
But I feel like it was worth it because, like you said, like the jewelry, the outfits, all of it was something that resonated so much with people. In fact, now that you say it.
Oh my God.
There is one in particular that I've actually kept from the show. These ones, you know. Ta-da! Yeah.
But if you have hacks to wear for longer hours when you're shooting, my God, television fashion.
You know, there's this ointment, I'm forgetting the name, you put that. Oh, like a
numbing cream. Okay.
Then we would also have those goats.
Can't chains.
Yeah. But honestly, it was still painful,
but
absolutely worth it.
Worth making trends.
Yeah, for sure.
Yes.
Like, so many people were just like, oh my God, we are so obsessed with the jewelry.
I remember those jhumkas you used to wear.
Yeah.
I think today people mix both metals.
Yeah.
Are you trying that out?
Yeah, so this like one piece is something that I picked up from Scotland.
Wow. Okay.
And I just love how cute it is. And I gifted the same one to my best friend, so both of us have
Like a friendship.
Yeah.
Something to remember each other.
Yeah.
So, let's start with shoes now.
Mm-hmm.
And let's talk about the sambas first. Kyunki meri nazar mein pehle aa rahe
hain. I think they're my all-time favorites. Hmm. I've been low-key like so obsessed. So, I feel like they're classic. They go with everything.
Yeah.
And I just feel like I can't get enough of them. It just really goes with my aesthetic.
Aesthetic. Yep. In general. That's great. And I love these boots, by the way. Thoda nazar dale in pe.
Yeah. So these ones, again, thrift. Okay. I picked them up from a store in Bandra. Actually, I have to give credit to Natasha, my stylist. She picked them up from me.
Okay.
And these, in fact, I wore them on Khatra also. A little uncomfortable in the sense, like, you're in heels and you're doing a shoot for Khatro, which is like...
How do you do that?
You just do it because fashion. So yeah, but I personally like, I love these boots. Also,
okay,
I have to show you one classic piece, which I felt like people really caught onto during Big Boss.
Okay.
These are Prajita Tour.
Oh my God, yes.
I have worn this so much. Like, my mom was so irritated after a point that why are you just like...
But these are so statement, no?
Yeah. Yeah, like, they are so statement. I feel like they would really make the outfit... I don't know. It would just elevate it in a way.
Yes.
And it really like stood out, guys. So...
I think a lot of Big Boss fans would remember these.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure because my mom after a point was like, why were you not wearing anything? I said, yeah, Prajita Tour does so nice. Yeah, so I had that phase.
Okay, so Nimrit, you know this show is called HF Raids. Mm-hmm. And I cannot go from here without raiding something from your lovely closet.
Of course, I'll be more than happy to do that.
Okay, great. So, yeah. What am I taking?
Well, I thought that since, you know, this is the first time anyone's reading anything from my closet apart from my friends. But I just felt like it's important to have some sentimental value attached. So, how about a piece of jewelry that I wore on Chudi Sarani?
Oh my God, I think my nani ma will only take it.
We love you, nani ma.
So cute.
Yeah. So these earrings, I don't know which episode, but I have indeed worn them on the show. And I just feel like this could be something meaningful and something nice to let go of. And I just hope whoever wears them, I hope you like them.
They will.
Yeah.
I'm gonna take these babies
away. Bye.
But anyways, thank you so much, Nimrit, for letting us invade your lovely walk-in wardrobe.
Thank you so much for taking out the time to invade my privacy on a day that I was feeling exceptionally blah, but you have made it amazing and very special.
Oh my
indeed.
God. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Till then, bye guys.
No, wait. We love you, Nani Ma.
So cute. Thank God.